moves out ahead of this thing because if the gust front, the strong winds, blow out ahead, it reduces the chance that a tornado will occur. You can see how fast those clouds are moving, and they are moving fairly quick. Here's the view then from downtown of this dark, ominous cloud. There you can see that lowered cloud base. Anything that sort of protrudes down underneath is potentially the wall cloud, and you know, that lowered cloud as it comes in from the north, you know, can, you know, anywhere along that line. Right now we got a severe thunderstorm warning, but I'll tell you, just looking at the radar and where we've got that lowered cloud, the fact that we've gotten these reports of tennis ball sized hail occurring right there in Fort Calhoun and likely still occurring. This is the hail mode of the radar. It shows you right in through here. And anywhere you've got that pink shading is probably, you know, something in order of 2 or 3 inch diameter hail occurring. You got to imagine the kind of wind it takes to lift up to produce that. It's studies have shown 95 miles per hour wind blowing upward to create baseball-sized hail. These rings, when the radar is showing that, are showing you where the radar thinks their strongest rotation. This is just about over Epley Airfield, the way the radar is showing it. And then this is that, again, the thunderstorm as it's dropping in here. Two things to note. This is the outflow. Let me pan this down so you can see a little bit further here. And the farther the outflow gets out ahead of the thunderstorm, the less likely there is for this thing to produce a tornado. But you can see how it's kind of kinked back up in through here. And the thunderstorm kind of is sort of continued to drop down. Now, as I broaden this out just a little bit, you know, here we are in Omaha, and folks in West Omaha are going to be missed by this storm. This thing is coming on down like this. But if you're in Council Bluffs, you're just about in the immediate path of this thing, and the storm has been producing tennis ball size hail. These camera pictures are just striking to me. When you look off to the north and look at, here's the radar, there's the livestock exchange camera looking off to the north. You can see how that low cloud base is, and the traffic moving, you know, looks like that, is that, that's kind of traffic there to the north and south. Then we're looking toward the downtown skyline, so you can see that low gray, dark sky. That's the storm that we're following. There are downtown camera here. We're looking off this one off to the north now. So again, there you are, and they see the lowest cloud base is just off to the north there, and also edging southeast. We can see the way you know, that we continue with that lowered cloud base. Here's that Lewis and Clark camera. Not sure. Yeah, there's a little light just to the west. Possibly pan that to the lowest cloud base, maybe. For me or not, but is the view where we're showing you the lowered cloud right in through here. That's where the strongest. So just keep panning off to the east here. So we kind of want to follow any of these little protrusions where the lowest clip right in through here, the lowest cloud base here, also through here. So this is just about now between Epley Airfield, which is immediately underneath here, and over into Council Bluffs. So this is a very strong thunderstorm continues.
Because what is, as you're pointing that out, I've got an eye here on our high resolution, what we call the tornado vortex signatures, right around the Crescent area. It keeps kind of bumping from east of Irvington around Crescent. The problem that we deal with on that aspect is there's Council Bluffs directly in the path of what this northwest to southeast flow is. Now, granted, we do not have a tornado warning in effect right now, but we are getting reports of a golf ball-sized hail around 60th and Rainwood.
48th and 680 baseball-sized hail right now.
All right. 48th and 680 baseball-sized hail right now. And obviously, this newest image actually showing you just now that southern edge of that storm is dropping down. That's going to be in the area right about where I am circling, right in this region right here. So that's about where our baseball hail is falling right now. And again, we're also starting to get golf ball size hail. Let's see here, around the Ponca Hills area, is that correct? I might have you guys go ahead and back me up on that one. To tennis ball / baseball size hail. And really what you'll notice here, I'm gonna clear this out here and get rid of these storm tracks quickly. But as this typically moves off towards the south and east, what you're gonna notice is, yeah, it's certainly a big impact for extreme eastern portions of Douglas County. But also as we make our way directly towards the Council Bluffs area, you'll see that storm come in off the top of your screen right there. And the area that we are certainly most concerned about is this region right in there. And again, that is all moving off towards the south and east.
Right. Tyson, I want to go back to our classic display of Super Doppler 7 here. And I'm highlighting, when we switch over onto this thing, the toward and away. So that's a pretty strong indication of rotation. Let me take those away so that we can just show you what that's telling you. That's saying that right in through here, This area has got winds coming in toward the radar at 74 miles an hour, and then these are going away from the radar at 58 miles an hour. So that's really, really strong rotation. Sometimes these storms will not produce a tornado, even though you got strong rotation, but typically these are these giant hail producers, as we're seeing at the present time. If we can go back to that SkyCam view here, because that is just remarkable. Now we're getting rain. Again, if you're in West Omaha, you're lucky you missed out on this thunderstorm. Really, anything west of looks like about, say, 72nd Street. Haven't seen too much. Which camera is that? That's from 70 Livestock Exchange. They're telling me, looking off to the east, there you can see the really, really strong thunderstorm. Left bottom part above the lights show you where it's not raining real hard yet, but that's sort of that south of Council Bluffs, from, say, south of Manawa and down. We're back on Lewis and Clark, panning the camera. Look at all those leaves down, smaller branches down. That's just kind of the aftermath of a hail-producing thunderstorm there. And of course, the camera breaks up a little bit.